an extreme adventure angler.
Wow! Man, that's a big fish!
On the hunt for a legendary predator, the Goonch catfish.
Extremely hot, no water. If you want to catch a big fish, you need to suffer.
A fearsome flesh eater with shark-like teeth.
Teeth that would penetrate its prey very, very deeply.
And a fabled taste for humans, dead or alive.
All of a sudden, something came up and just pulled it under.
Yes, well, he's coming from the current.
Yes, it's Goonch, guys, it's Goonch.
Is this river killer now driven to prey on man and beast?
What a monster. Goonch, giant devil catfish.
It's fisherman versus infamous man-eater.
Oh.
Hooked, monster fish, giant devil catfish.
Yes, Goonch, Goonch.
For centuries, legends have described man-eating freshwater monsters. The ravenous piranha. The fierce Wells catfish. And recently, another supersized species more terrifying than them all. The Goonch. Found in the world's most remote places. Said to feed on the burnt bodies of funeral pyres. Now, reports of human attacks are making headlines. Some believe the stories are macabre myths. Others fear this flesh eater may be on the hunt for new prey.
The Goonch is a hot topic with the media right now. Something that could eat you is scary. It fascinates the public. Fishes in particular, they're these scary monsters of the deep. You can't really see them coming at you. They often live in muddy waters. They're scary things.
World-renowned explorer, adventurer, and extreme angler Jakub Wagner is determined to find out what is myth and what is real. By catching his own monster Goonch, meeting this mysterious alpha predator face to face. Northern India, near the border of Tibet and Nepal. Here, a river system of the great Ganges may be under siege. In the last two decades, the Kali River has been the epicenter of three potential Goonch attacks. Yet in recent months, Goonch sightings on the Ram Ganga have grown. These waters may be the Goonch's new human hunting ground.
There is the river Ram Ganga.
Okay.
Here, Jakub is thousands of kilometers from his native Czech Republic. Embarking on a 7-day expedition, hunting the ultimate alleged man-eater.
I hope we can get a Goonch over there.
Adventure fishing is Jakub's lifetime obsession. From Texas to Thailand, as a highly accomplished sportsman and intrepid traveler, the anglers battled the biggest and baddest monster fish on Earth. Breaking multiple world records, tracking and identifying rare species in habitats far off the grid. Now, upping the ante, the master fisherman's driven by a single goal, finding a killer in its elusive lair. On a mission that may be the most dangerous showdown of his career.
I've caught huge catfish before, but Goonch is different. This catfish has these huge shark-like teeth, and it's rumored to actually eat humans. We are trying to find very rare fish, Goonch, Bagaris yarili in Latin name. And the thing is, we don't know really nothing about this species. And we need to find this fish. So we have to travel different parts of the river.
day one of seven, 8 a.m., the banks of the Ramganga River. Yakub knows, alone, his odds of catching a goonch are almost impossible.
Should be fine already.
Enlisting the help of a local fisherman and a rafting guide, Yakub prepares to head nearly 50 kilometers downriver, deeper into the Himalayan wilds. There, he plans to meet up with the region's most respected goonch guide, Vinay Padola.
I'm really excited. I don't know what to expect.
Yes, I think that's a little bit more.
The goonch is only one potential danger. The Ramganga is also home to deadly tigers, snakes, and crocodiles. And with crushing humidity, temperatures regularly surpass a scorching 37 degrees.
Let's go.
Okay.
It's the end of the dry season, and water levels are perilously low. The team pushes ahead to deeper currents and churning rapids. It's a dangerous course, but the one-week expedition has little time. To rendezvous with their goonch guide, the river's faster than the mountain roads. Now, as they head further from civilization, they move closer to the hunting ground of the goonch. A whopper dating back over a million years, the goonch catfish is very real. Native to Southeast Asia, some believe the biggest goonch may stretch nearly 2 meters, weighing over 110 kilograms. At any size, the goonch's jutting teeth and wide mouth turn it into an assassin. So fierce, it's nicknamed the Devil Catfish.
The goonch is a very adept predator. It has this suctorial motion that could suck in large prey, and then it has these big teeth to hold onto it. And there's probably not another catfish that could eat nearly as large a prey or have such strong suctorial pressures to suck prey in. I think it's certainly conceivable that the goonch might attack a human being.
Two p.m. Bikisane. From raft back to hired jeep, Yakub arrives in time to meet fishing guide Vinay Padola.
Hi, Vinay. Nice to meet you.
How are you? Excellent.
Well, how is your fishing?
It's been all right. Water's been coming up, but it's been all right.
Okay. I haven't caught a goonch so far, so I hope you can help me.
Absolutely.
So let's see the river.
Let's do that. But before that, we need to take blessings. So let's do that first.
Okay.
A passionate angler and local wilderness expert, Vinay has over 30 years' experience fishing these waters. As a professional guide, Vinay's led many foreign anglers to the region's biggest fish. He's also one of the few people on Earth who's studied the fabled goonch firsthand. The team heads first to the local ashram. A priest bestows blessings. Yakub hopes this holy place will bring him luck and entice the river to give up an adversary with a frightening reputation. There's no concrete proof of anyone dying by a goonch assault, but Vinay has heard locals describe devastating attacks.
I know of a boy which got taken by a fish in the Kali River, and I've spoken to the boy's mother. She is still in a state of shock.
The late 1980s. A local mother's young son splashes in the river shallows. Until something strikes from below. pulled under, the boy disappears, never seen again. Vinay has also heard of livestock gone missing with no warning.
I spoke to a person who was eyewitness to his buffalo being grabbed by something and pulled underwater.
And there's another chilling local belief that goons stalk the waters below funeral pyres. Open-air cremations are a sacred Hindu tradition. As wooden burial platforms burn, human remains fall or are pushed into the waters beneath.
Oh, Hindus were burned their dead. When a person dies, the body is taken to a river. Even if a dead body is partially burnt, it is put into the river and the funeral is over. Half-burnt bodies, obviously, they leave a scent trail.
The Kali and Ramganga rivers are common funeral pyre sites. Some experts think, as hungry river scavengers, the goonch flock here, vulture fish cruising for a macabre but easy meal, that this is how the goonch grow so large, and why the fish may now have a taste for live human meat. One thing's certain, thanks to a trait called indeterminate growth, the longer goonch live, the bigger they grow. With virtually no natural predators, flesh-feeding alpha goonch can reach terrifying proportions, potentially large enough to hunt a human target. Some locals, like Vinay, believe the attacks may be perpetrated by just a few renegade goonch, or even a single lone predator with a grisly appetite.
Fish actually get used to consuming the dead bodies. Maybe there's one particular fish which has taken a liking to dead bodies. Maybe there was someone close to the dead body or something, and someone was vibrating in the right manner, and this one went for it. And from there on, it's developed a taste for human beings or anything in the shallows which moves.
Yet others residing near the river fear a far scarier scenario. The goonch's craving for human flesh is a recent development. As its natural habitat faces construction, pollution, and overfishing, the ancient species may be forced to find new food, including Homo sapiens, dead or alive. Adaptive feeding is a common phenomenon among successful predators.
The fishes will be pushed into peripheral habitats. Their food sources may be taken away. They're going to be shifting and maybe preying on other things.
And while in some habitats, aggressive commercial fishing and poaching threaten the goonch with extinction, it's humans who may be most in danger here. At 3 p.m., Vinay's intimate knowledge of the river leads the team to an ideal goonch hideout, a rocky underwater lair near recent goonch sighting Ground Zero.
Wow, this pool looks really great. Let's try it, yeah.
We cast our bait into a very deep pool where goonch lives. We are getting closer to the place where big goonch sightings happen. I'm so excited to catch this fish, big enough to eat a human.
But something is definitely tasting the fish.
Yes. Very strange.
It's not current because otherwise it would move left or right, but not towards us.
Maybe eels, big eels?
Maybe. Yeah, no. Did you see it?
Towards us.
Already it's three or four times, you know?
Yeah.
Yakub feels a sudden tug, a bite. The powerful fish pulls hard against his line.
I'm reeling as fast as I can. I'm praying it's a big gunch, but the water is murky. I'm thinking it can be something else. But I'm so excited to see the giant devil catfish. I just want to get it in as fast as I can.
The fighting whopper is surprisingly strong. In muddy waters, Yakub has no way of knowing what's on the end of his line. At any moment, the angler fears his line might snap under pressure. He gives a strong tug and gets the fish to the surface.
Beautiful, Masha.
It's no gunch, but it is one of the most coveted freshwater fish on Earth.
Beautiful.
A golden mashir.
I didn't expect to catch mashir. The bait was there for the gunch, and I'm using strong steel wire and two big single hooks. So I really didn't expect that, but it's a beautiful fish. I'm very happy about it. If you hold the fish.
Now, with the fish on shore, Yakub reaches in to remove the hook.
Yeah, I'm trying to get the hook. Yeah, that's it.
Before releasing the fish, the angler wants to examine his first ever mashir conquest. Yep. Okay. And the first catch of the Ramgunga expedition.
Pure gold.
Marked by colorful fins, puckered mouths, and golden scales, golden mashir are primarily found in these Himalayan waters. One of the world's largest carp, they're able to reach nearly 3 meters, weighing 68 kilos. Prized for their size, unique beauty, and power, for experienced anglers, mighty mashir are some of the toughest freshwater contenders.
How much is it?
23 pounds.
That's a good fish.
Very nice fish.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Yakub guides the mashir back to open water.
It's not a gunch, but I'm extremely happy that I can release this beautiful fish. Pure gold. Goodbye. See you next time.
It survived the catch, but the same mashir may be destined for death by gunch.
The gunch is physically capable of eating large prey because it itself is large.
Catfish are notoriously greedy. Prawns and smaller fish are a common diet staple. Yet what could drive a gunch to crave mammal meat? Ocean predators like sharks are famous for bloody mammal kills. But what creates a flesh eater in a river?
In any ecosystem, there are predators evolved to eat meat simply because it's a high protein source. Everything needs to ingest protein. Typically, if you've got a high protein diet, you're going to grow bigger.
The gunch isn't the only freshwater stalker that may be hunting high protein mammal prey. One of the most infamous meat-eating river beasts is the piranha. Though a single piranha rarely grows longer than 45 centimeters, these razor-toothed hunters attack in marauding mobs. Deadly packs are known to strip the meat off big kills in minutes, leaving only bones behind.
Piranha is special for the flesh-eating habits, basically, and its ability to take chunks of meat out of its prey. It has these very specialized teeth, triangular-shaped teeth with sharp edges that are very good at cutting into things and taking chunks out of them.
Yakub is no stranger to flesh-eating piranha. In 2008, canoeing on the Amazon River, Yakub casts, reels, and gets a strike. An aggressive fish whips and flails across the surface. A piranha. Getting it in the boat, Yakub tries to show the camera his catch's dagger teeth. But the fish snaps, tearing into Yakub's hand. the cuts deep, proof of a piranha's power. It's a bloody tangle with a flesh eater's instinct for self-defense. Yet when it comes to devil catfish, Yakub wonders, when goonch attack, are they defending or hunting? Back at the Ramganga, day 2, 8 a.m. After searching for 2 days, Yakub is determined to snare a goonch.
You see the place over there, you know, the small stream.
Changing tactics, the angler scans the water for the perfect spot to drop his rock-weighted bait by hand. An underwater nook where goonch like to hunt.
Okay, let's go.
I just need to organize myself. Stone, bait, and swim.
Paddling across, Yakub battles strong currents. Aware at all times he's in the unusual habitat of a fabled man-eater. Wading in the same waters that swirl around funeral pyres and their human remains.
What do you think? Very strong current.
Now, trying to time his drop with the water flow, Yakub must keep his bait from falling too deep between underwater boulders. But just as Yakub releases the bait, he spots a problem. Old abandoned fishing lines. Tied to bottles for ballast, the lines have been left behind by local fishermen. Now, they pose a danger. If they tangle with Yakub's active fishing line, they could cost him a goonch catch.
Thank you.
To clear them, Yakub heads back into the rushing current. He grabs the first of several bottle lines. Then, something goes wrong. As Yakub fights to stay upright, the river sweeps him downstream. Marshaling his strength, Yakub muscles his way back towards his targets. Reaching under, he grabs the remaining lines and yanks them as hard as he can. Success. He swims back to the bank.
It's very interesting to swim in the same river where they burn their bodies when they die. So I'm swimming in the river where thousands and thousands of people are burned every year.
Yakub resists fatigue, knowing a flesh-eating goonch may be lurking below. He hopes his weighted bait has landed near a river lair where goonch hunt, kill, and feed.
I can tell you the current is quite strong. I hope we can catch this fish.
Deep in goonch territory, Yakub may only truly be safe on dry land. After one alleged local attack, some believe even wading in these waters can be dangerous. 1988, the Kali River on the Indian-Nepal border. A 17-year-old boy wades into the water to cool off. The boy's girlfriend is nearby, with no idea what's stalking him below. But no one sees what happens next. Something suddenly grabs him, sucking him under, dragging him into the deep. A 3-day river search covers nearly a 5-kilometer stretch and turns up no remains. Many believe the young man was swallowed whole. Was the mysterious killer a giant goonch? The incident only fans the flames of the river beast's grisly reputation. Continuing his quest for the legendary man-eater, Yakub battles the dry season's blazing midday heat.
Whoa, This happens with all these stones around. Extreme heat, getting into the water. This is extreme fishing.
He heads even deeper down the Ramganga River. Six p.m. Early evening. A deep water bend in the river. Reaching a bluff overlooking a potential devil catfish lair, Yakub sets up camp. He wants to test a theory that goonch, like many catfish, are active night hunters.
One last cast before the dark. Actually, we don't know if goonch eat in the day or only in the night, so we have to try it.
Several hours later, as everyone sleeps, a bite. But in the pitch black, Yakub can't get out of his tent in time. The next morning, it's a disappointing blow.
We had around 1:30. It was like definitely goonch. But what happened? We couldn't find a way from the tent, or we didn't find a zip in time, so we lost the fish.
Day 3 of 7, 8 a.m. Yakub presses on. The night's missed catch suggests the expedition is zeroing in on prime goonch territory. The fishermen push onwards.
That could be a very good place over there.
10 a.m. downriver, drawing even closer to the recent goonch sightings.
If you're fishing for them in the daytime, then you have to know where the fish lie, the exact spot. So
experienced guide Vinay Badola believes the team's found a goonch hotspot. A perfect storm of favorable conditions. Fast-moving water, deep rocky pools, and an abundant food supply. Targets for hungry goonch. Yakub's now on high alert. He must conserve his strength in the heat, so he waits near his baited line.
Hello, Texas!
A powerful strike.
Nice, good fish. Good fish. Strong fish, guys. It's very strong fish.
Now, it's a race against time.
We'll get it back later. Yeah, a little bit more. Yeah.
Yakub fears if the fish is a goonch, its razor teeth could snap his line in two, or hopelessly mangle the metal leader.
More to the left. Just bring the fish to him.
As Vinay coaches, Yakub struggles to stay hooked.
It's very strong fish.
Heading to the rock.
Okay.
But as the monster fights, trying to shake the hook, Yakub risks another line-cutting danger.
Have to be very careful with all these rocks in the water.
Keep the pressure on it. Keep the pressure on.
It's a very strong fish.
Under the water, the fish dives straight for the river's deepest cracks.
He's trying to get under the rock over there.
It's a trademark move of a heavyweight catfish.
Don't let it sit down. Just keep it swimming. Don't let it sit down.
I'm trying.
If the whopper finds a dent to hide in, it could stress the line to its breaking point. Refusing to quit, with a strong heave, Yakub wrestles the beast to the surface.
Goonch! Goonch! Yes! Yes! Yes!
It's a goonch. Yakub has no time to stop, but it's astonishing to see the mysterious monster fish in the flesh.
Goonch, finally I caught one! Yes! Woo!
The goonch is so unwieldy, Jakub's convinced to land it, he's gotta wrangle it by hand.
Let's go through the water.
Jakub, careful, careful.
Yeah.
It gets deep very quickly.
Don't make a mistake now. He's so heavy, he's like stone. I tried to grab his tail.
At last, with a final grab.
Yes!
He's got the flesh eater in his arms.
What a beautiful fish!
Wow.
Look at this.
Awesome.
What a fish, what a creature. What a monster. Oh, goon giant devil catfish.
The goonch's wide, flattened body is built like a battering ram. Thick muscle covers a bony skeleton wrapped in a tough keratin skin, similar to human fingernails.
And look at these tiny small eyes and these whiskers, you know, and it's very interesting that goonch has bone in these whiskers. I don't know any other catfish which is both inside the whiskers and the huge mouth full of big teeth. This is something, you know, prehistoric.
And like a shark, the goonch's triangle-shaped teeth are designed to stab and shred flesh.
Look at the head. It's like stone. That's why he's so heavy. You know? Look. Like stone. I would really love to stick my hand into his stomach, you know, to search what he eats. But I will not make it because he would definitely bite me. I can imagine he's sitting on the bottom, you know, without single movement.
Exactly.
You know, and then a small fish is swimming around, or even big fish.
Exactly.
Let's unhook the fish. We have to be very careful.
Jakub estimates the goonch is over 1 meter and 20 long, weighing roughly 36 kilos.
What do you think? This fish is probably around 1 meter 50. The really monsters, they can grow, what do you think, about 3 meters?
3 meters should be a good possibility.
Okay. And such a big monster, I can understand now that such a big fish could be able to attack even adult person.
Yeah, quite comfortably. Because a 3 meter fish would have a head which is about this broad. And if it's this broad, that's broader than my shoulders, I'm sure it could have a go at human beings.
In potential human attack terms, a large catfish can bite and swallow more than 10% of its body weight. Based on this goonch's size, it could consume part of a human leg or arm. Woo! Jakub knows it's dangerous for goonch to be too long out of water. With a last look, he releases the beast.
And I need to continue with my fishing to find an even bigger one. I let you go now.
Jakub's convinced a massive man-eater's still out there. Local attack stories describe a much larger specimen. A monster-sized flesh-eating fish. A devil catfish, big enough to devour far more than a human arm. Jakub refuses to rest until he meets a giant goonch face to face. Seven. After landing a 1 meter 20 and 36 kilo goonch, Jakub Wagner and his team have only 3 days left to catch a fabled devil catfish big enough to devour a human. They push closer to the epicenter of prior goonch sightings.
We are crossing small river. Do we have a goonch here as well?
maybe goonch.
Yeah. I hope they will not attack our jeep.
Heading deeper off the grid, the land eventually becomes too rugged for the jeep. To continue on, Jakub and his guide Vinay need specialized transportation.
We are trying to get on the very secret spot where should be a monster gunch. But only elephant can take us there. This is absolutely amazing place, Vinay.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Vinay's secret spot is deep in wild tiger country. So dangerous, even experienced guides won't cross the terrain on foot. In India, tiger attacks are a constant threat. Moving further into isolated wilderness, today, the Goonch thrives in such remote locations. But many fear as civilization pushes closer, the hungry hunters are adopting a new diet of livestock and human remains, even targeting live human prey, behaving exactly like another fabled man-eating catfish. The Wells.
The Wells catfish is clearly special because of its size. It's one of the biggest freshwater fishes in the world, and simply put, it's huge.
The only flesh-eating monster fish comparable to a goonch. Meet Europe's largest whopper catfish. Wells can grow nearly 5 meters, weighing almost 300 kilos. Their gaping mouths sport rows of sandpaper teeth, and these beasts have a definite taste for meat. Wells frequently eat frogs, rats, and birds. The aggressive predators have also reportedly attacked humans in European waterways far closer to civilization than the Goonch's remote Indian hunting grounds. June 4th, 2008. Berlin. A local lake's cool waters draw bathers escaping from the summer heat. A young woman swims with a friend. Until she feels something latch onto her leg. Splashing away, she manages to escape. At the hospital, doctors treat a crescent-shaped bite on her left calf, the signature chomp of a Wells catfish. Others in the area report similar wounds. The attacks make headlines. Officials believe a few aggressive Wells catfish are just defending their mating turf. But many wonder, like the alleged victims of the Goonch, could this fierce river predator be test-biting humans as potential prey? To Jakub, the aggressive Wells is also a familiar rival.
Catching a big goonch is not my first big catfish. In fact, I caught the biggest Wells catfish in the world. Bigger than me, big enough to swallow a human. And I can tell you, these fish can put up monster fights.
Early in his quest for the world's biggest monster fish, a young Jakub cut his teeth wrangling a man-sized Wells. Then, in April 2007, he hooked an even bigger Wells whopper, a record-breaking catch measuring over 2.40 meters long, weighing 109 kilos. For Jakub, the unforgettable encounter made a powerful impression, fueling his ambition to conquer the world's other mythical man-eating catfish. Now, in search of a whopper goonch said to have a taste for blood.
What a thing, jungle, be careful.
Jakub and Vinay watch for predators on land, making their way to the river location.
If you are on the back of elephant like this, is it safe?
Safer than walking around on foot.
But our elephant is a bit nervous about wild elephants and tigers, which is why she's a little jittery at the moment.
So do you think they are around?
Yes, of course.
Vinay, do you see the tiger prints over there? They are huge.
Yes, it's quite a big one too.
And they are quite fresh.
Yes. Let's take another route.
Okay, let's go somewhere else.
Day 5 of 7. Time is running out. With only 2 days remaining on the expedition, the team arrives at Vinay's chosen spot. Surrounded by expansive wilderness, they're miles from civilization and any emergency help. Yakub's skill and determination face the ultimate test.
Now let's go for Gunch.
Then, a strike.
It's a big fish. You can really feel the power. This time I'm thinking the fish is fighting just like a gunch. The first thing what gunch does, surge down to the bottom of the river. And it's so heavy, like concrete. As I try to pull, it feels like my arms will come out of their sockets.
Whatever he's hooked, the beast below nearly rips the rod out of Yakub's hands.
She's trying to save me.
Don't let it sit down. Don't let it sit down. Oh, poor man. It's a big one.
It's a big fish. Woohoo! It's a big fish. Oh.
Deep in the Indian jungle, angler Yakub Wagner struggles against a powerful force in the water. He grips the fishing rod as tight as he can. But the beast fights back. The whopper makes a run, trying to hide in a hole below, pulling the line dangerously taut. The fish darts through a minefield of jagged rocks.
I have to move. She's trying to snag me behind the stone.
In this tug of war, Yakub is reeling hard, terrified he'll lose his grip.
She's trying to save me.
Local veteran Vinay is convinced the only strategy is to tire the fish out.
Careful now, keep the pressure on it.
Wow! Oh, man, that's a big good fish.
One. Good
it's
fish, good
60
fish.
Kilos.
But one slip on the river's jagged rocks could cost Yakub the catch.
Look!
Oh, man.
Oh, it's a big one, man.
The more he fights it, the more Yakub is convinced he has a monster goonch on the line, big enough to attack and consume human prey.
I can tell you there's a fish what we want.
But the fish is just as determined.
I don't know where is he.
It dives down, seeking refuge in the lowest crag it can find. Then, a big bony barbel breaks the surface.
Wow! That's gunch!
Attached, the gaping mouth of a giant.
It's a big gunch! Yes!
Yakub's hunch was right. He's up against a mammoth specimen.
Wow! That's a big gunch! Whoa! That's a monster!
The angler has no time to hesitate.
Yes!
Whoa!
He's got the Goliath fish in reach.
Yes, my friend, yes.
Woo! Woo! Yes!
Wow, oh wow.
That's the fish, that's the monster.
Yakub and his crew want to get the goonch on a weighing mat fast.
Okay. Lift the tail a bit more.
It takes 3 to manhandle this huge devil catfish into shallow waters.
I still can't believe it.
The fish stretches a staggering 1.88 meters.
1, 2, 3.
tipping the scale at over 74 kilos, a world record.
Yes, man, thank you very much. Thank you very much. What a beast. Beautiful fish. Thank you, guys.
Now, Jakub needs to get the fish back into the water for a safe release. But there's one measurement left. Examining the Goonch's jaws up close.
Look at this huge mouth and these fantastic teeth. They are like sharks. I would be nearly able to stick my... Oh no, nearly. I am in the mouth of Goonch. Look. I can easily imagine that this fish would be able to grab my leg and pull me in. So yeah, this beast would be able to kill human beings.
Up close with the legendary predator, Jakub concludes this killer catfish has the strength, the weaponry, and the size to be a lethal danger in the water.
Do you have it like this?
Though there's no way to know whether this or any other single specimen can or has taken a human victim, the Goonch is astonishing.
Yes! Guys, thank you very much, because I can tell you, this is the trip. Absolutely. This is the fish of our lifetime.
For sure.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much.
Okay, let's release this beauty.
Thank you so much for this.
This is the king of the river.
Stuff of dreams.
King of the river, Ramganga.
Jakub, Vinay, and the team set their record-setting catch free, safe to grow and hunt another day.